Today we are going to start with paper toll. Paper toll is nothing but a 3D decoupage art in which we usually do fussy cutting for each and every designs. But in this sheet, you are already provided the fussy cut templates. You need not cut. And there are numberings that is provided on the sheet. According to that, we will work. Today we will work with this roses in this sheet. You have to remove like this each and every fussy cut design. Now we will need a black cardstock sizing 10.5 by 5.75 that I am taking. Other white cardstock sizing 5 by 5.5, and one more black cardstock sizing 4.75 by 5.25. These are the three cardstocks. You have to cut according to the sizes. Now you have to take a scoreboard and just score it at 5.25, because our paper size is 10.5 by 5.75, so 10.5 half is 5.25, and give it a fold like this. Once you do the fold from the back side, so you have to give it a crisp fold. If you don't have a bone folder, you can just use your scissor, and the back side of the scissor, just press it like this and you will get a proper fold. Now once you are done doing this, take the cardstock, the white one, I usually don't work with Fevicol. Here we get Fevibond, so I am using Fevibond. While applying the glue, be very careful that you are just applying a bit of glue. If you end up using too much of glue, you will just spoil the paper and the project, because the glue will come out from by pressing this. Make sure that you are leaving equal distance from all four sides while sticking. This black layer. Similarly, I will stick this as well. This is how we give the layering to the card. It always gives you a better look rather than working with a single paper. This is my first free tutorial. I am making a very simple card so that you know the basic techniques for the paper toll. This is how your base for the card is ready. We'll keep this on side. Now coming back to the paper toll designs. This is the base that we are going to use. So what you have to do is you have to cut this design like this. I will show you how to cut. The basic of cutting is, while you cut, never turn your scissors. Always keep on turning your paper according to the shape you want to cut. Like suppose I am cutting this, and always take a comfortable scissor that you are comfortable with. Sorry, just a second. Before cutting this, what you have to do is, take a craft cutting knife and cut this extra part. Like I have cut this one before cutting the design, because you can just hold it firmly if you don't cut the design. So, like this, you have to move your cutting knife and just turn the paper according to your cutting knife and cut the desired part that is not required in the design. This is how this extra part is cut. Now here also there is an extra part that we will cut. You may spoil few of your blades while doing this cutting. This is how the cutting is done. This is the base that we are going to use. So, what you have to do is, you have to cut this design like this. I will show you how to cut. The basic of cutting is, while you cut, never turn your scissors. Always keep on turning your paper according to the shape you want to cut. Like suppose I am cutting this. Always take a comfortable scissor that you are comfortable with. Sorry, just a second. Before cutting this, what you have to do is, take a craft cutting knife and cut this extra part. Like I have cut this one before cutting the design, because you can just hold it firmly if you don't cut the design. So like this, you have to move your cutting knife and just turn the paper according to your cutting knife and cut the desired part that is not required in the design. So this is how this extra part is cut. Now here also there is an extra part that we will cut. Thank you. You may spoil few of your blades while doing this cutting. Now we will cut the outer design. So for this you have to move your paper. Now see, here we are going to turn the paper and not the scissor. Scissor I am just adjusting according to the design. You have to be very precise while cutting this. If you don't have a good finishing while cutting, your card won't look good. And always hold your paper from the end. This is a basic mistake that people do while doing a fussy cut. This is how we are done with this cutting. Now you have to take an embossing pad. This is a perforating pad. The first design, the first layer on which number one is written, that you won't do anything other than the cutting part. Leave it like this only. Now this is the second part. For this, what you will do is you will emboss it from the back side like this. Just rub it from the sides like this. Give it a good pressure so that this part gets a good turning. Then similarly you will do on the flowers. You need this embossing tool and just draw the line from the front side like this. Same way you have to do with the other flowers as well. This will come on top of this. So from the back side we will emboss it like this. And then same way from the front side like this. This is done. I have already embossed this part. This is the last part that is remaining. So we are done the embossing part. Now we will do the layering for this. Since we are making a card, we can even apply Fevicol or else Mod Podge. Usually what you do, if you are doing on a canvas, you have to apply the Mod Podge on the base. But since I am doing it on a card, you have to apply the Mod Podge here. Don't apply too much of it. While sticking this, you have to decide where you are going to place. But since I am doing it on a card, to apply the Mod Podge here. Don't apply too much of it. While sticking this, you have to decide where you are going to place. So I want to place this over here. Like this. Take a debit card or something. Credit card, debit card, any will do. And if you have a squeezy, so you can even take the squeezy and just apply it like this so that the bubbles does not come. This is done. You have to use silicone glue or else Resibond. Both are same. Take silicone glue and apply it the back side where you have done the embossing. Silicone glue gives a 3D effect. That is the reason we are using silicone glue. Now this is B2. This was B1. Now we are placing B2 on this. While placing, be careful that your design falls exactly on the design that it is there on the base. This design exactly. This is done. Now we will take this B5. Stick it like this. See how a 3D layer is formed. Now the last part, that is B6, is left. this B6 part will come over here. Let it dry. Now we will stick a sentiment like congratulations with love, whatever you want to stick from the sheet that is provided. Good luck. So here I want to stick this congratulations and I will just place it over here. Here what you can do is just give it a layering of white border and a black border. It will look more beautiful. So I will do that and then we will stick this. So we have cut this part according to the size. Now again you have to stick it in such a way that all four sides are equal and then stick this. This is done. Now we will take this B5 and stick it like this. How a 3D layer is formed. Now the last part, that is B6, is left. Now this B6 part will come over here. Stick a sentiment like congratulations with love, whatever you want to stick from the sheet that is provided. Good luck. So here I want to stick this congratulations and I will just place it over here. Here what you can do is just give it a layering of white border and a black border. It will look more beautiful. So I will do that and then we will stick this. We have cut this part according to the size. Now again you have to stick it in such a way that all four sides are equal and then stick this. Stick this. So we have cut this part according to the size. Now again you have to stick it in such a way that all four sides are equal, and then stick this. This is how. This is done. And this will stick the sentiment as congratulations on the card. And the card will be complete. This is the simple card that we have done today. This is how the cup looks.